Merry Christmas, everybody. Merry Christmas. It's Christmas Eve today, and unfortunately, we don't have any snow outside. So it's kind of hard for me to feel the Christmas spirit without snow. I wonder how the people in California are feeling about that. I guess for them, that is a every year norm, I suppose. All right, moving on. Today, again, we are playing Path of Exile. A free-to-play game, and over here we are at the login screen, and immediately what I see is Winter Mystery Box available until January 5th. I wonder what that is. Oh well, we're gonna check it out later. So I'm logging in into my account, and here it is. There's my character, Tigger Tail, level 25, Shadow. I still don't know what that is. Let's play. Alrighty, and we're over here in the main city of Act 2. So as I said over here, we have four acts, as far as I know, which are four different maps or four different worlds that we can play in, and as we progress more and more, we are moving on to Act 2, then Act 3, and Act 4. This is the map of Act 2 where we're at right now at the moment. We are over here in the main town, which is the safe area, the safe zone. It's called the Forest Encampment Town. I currently have on Steam, I believe, something like 46 hours already that I have been playing that game. So I pretty much now know what's going on in the game. I love the game, by the way. If I have to categorize that game, it's pretty much a Barbie game. I mean, really, it's a Barbie game because all you do over here is, besides fighting the enemies, You're looting, and you have an inventory. There is the inventory, so pretty much you have this is the things that I have right now. So it's a dress-up game. You have I have a helmet, I have a armor set, gloves, I have boots, I have a belt, I have two weapons, one for each hand, and I can switch my weapons. I have a bow, arrows, I have an amulet. And you can find different pieces of amulets, rings, and different pieces of helmets, armors, all kinds of stuff. So it's a dress-up game. You always have to just change your clothes. They have different stats. You see over here that you can insert diamonds, and how you insert diamonds or gems. Pretty much when you find an armor, I found this outside the city when I was fighting with enemies. This has two slots, so that means that you can insert a red gem into this slot over here and a blue gem over here. So you have to match the color of the gem with the color of the slot. Now if they're connected, now these are not connected, but if they're connected as they are over here, there is two types of gems, alright? So there is the support gems and the main gems. Support gems act as a support force to the main gem, which is not important at all. Okay, so now that we know that this is a dress-up Barbie game with heavy action in it, we can come to any of the people over here and, certain people over here and trade stuff with them. So, for example, you do favors for these guys, and instead you can trade with them. Not to go back to her people. I say we take your traitor's heart to the chief. Ask that the warriors in black leave us. Okay. I sleep less, but no more, thanks to you. Helena gave me this. Use it or cast it away. I do not care. I have no time for Helena's breed of peace. Yes, I did a favor for this guy, and now he's rewarding me with, oh my god, what am I gonna do right now? I don't have any space to take. With one of these, I can choose a reward. What is that? Channel lightning through your hands, adding lightning damage to spell. Okay. Fire through your hands, adding fire to your physical damage. Okay, I'm gonna go with performs an attack that gives the character a frenzy charge if it hits. I'm gonna go with the red gem because I gotta tell you, red is a very fine gem, a very hard gem to find. I'm sorry. Frick. You know what? I don't know what I'm gonna do now. I'm just gonna destroy this just so I can get a reward. Well, that was a waste. Alright. Okay, thank you. Now, I also helped another lady over here, and I'm gonna find her. She's somewhere over here. Once you find somebody outside of this encampment and help them out, they come to the encampment, they become a vendor, and you can sell stuff to them, and in return they give you other stuff. So this game is based on barter system. There is no money or currency, but you give something and they give you something instead, and it's all object based, which is cool. It's awesome. So yeah, okay, let's see. Intruders in Black, quest complete. You have rescued Helena from the Chamber of Sins and have been rewarded by Groost. Well, I know that, but thank you. All right, let me go to my chest. We have a chest where we can store stuff. Okay, we have a support gem. I'm just gonna put it over here. We have this gem. I'm gonna put it over here. We have some flasks. As you can see, these flasks are the flasks over here. One is for blood, which is your life. It's reflected in this orb over here. And then you have the mana, which is your magical abilities to cast magic. And I put a bottle of this over here, and then it's reflected over here. Because my inventory is going to be closed for most of the time when I play, I can see the level over here of my mana and the level of my blood over here. Pretty neat. Sweet. Alright. Okay. When you trade with vendors, if you have three of the same flasks, you trade them to the vendor, and in return, he gives you back, or she gives you back, a bigger flask that can hold more blood or more mana. And that is one recipe that I have found out it works. So there's many recipes and many variations. You never know what you're going to get when you trade with them, what they're going to give you in return of the objects that you give them. But that's one thing that I know, that if you give them three of the same flasks, they're going to give you a larger one, which is cool. So, okay. This is corrupt. Okay, I'm going to put that in my chest. Alright. And, what else? This I'm gonna sell. Some I can sell, some not. These rings I'm gonna keep over here. And Fridge. Okay. I'm gonna keep these here. These here. Alright. Okay, as you can see over here, unidentified, I'm sorry. What does that mean? That means that we don't know what this item is. I mean, we kinda can tell you're spiritual. How we can find out is Scroll of Wisdom. There it is. Now it tells us that it has plus 10% to lightning resistance, reflects 4 physical damage to melee attackers. Yeah, not really worth keeping. I'm gonna sell it. Let's find this girl that I helped outside the woods, which was Tora.
What do you need?
I want to sell items to you, lady. Alright. Take this. Unidentified. Is it worth using my scroll of wisdom to identify this object. Sure, why not? Right click and left click onto the thing. Holy moly, that's a pretty good thing. I'm still gonna sell it. I don't want it. Alright. What is it? Accept. Okay, let's put this here. Let's put this here. And let's go out for another... No. I don't want to. This is a teleport. I step over here, it opens the map, and wherever I have revealed another teleport, I can be teleported to instantly. Isn't that cool? So over here, I've been here, but there was no teleport. Over here, there was, and over here, there was. I don't know what that is, Chamber of Sins. But let's try going here. Oh, Royty, let me see what you guys have for me. Oh, what's happening? Oh, okay, so these are slots with special abilities that I can reload, and this is my right click. Okay, I love these arrows. Now, as you can see, these arrows are magical arrows. They're using magic, and it's taking it out of my mana over here. And my mana over here is coming from the flask that I have loaded into my inventory in this slot over here. Pretty cool. So, over here in the upper right corner, we have the map that it's telling us where we're at. We're currently revealing it. Every time we visit the same place, it's not the same place. The game randomizes the place and makes it different. So pretty much you cannot really remember it, because it's going to be different the next time around. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. I am not a paid promoter for this game. I want to tell you that right now. I am just enjoying playing it. And I hope you guys enjoy it too. Over here on the right side, we have all the gems that I have inserted into my clothing and my other stuff. So yeah, pretty much all these gems are displayed over here, and I can level them up as I am leveling up by killing enemies and using their abilities, the gems' abilities to kill enemies. Ooh, lapis amulet. My, I'm gonna take this with me and see what it is. Ooh-hoo. Ooh, what's going on? Okay, so far nothing. Chaos orb. Yeah, pretty much when I started playing this game, I tried finding some helpful tips online of how to play this game. And the two people that I found on YouTube that have really extensive explanation of how this game works. So the two people are, I believe the guy's name was Creeparian. Let me see what his name is. Okay, Creeparian, and the other guy is Ziggy D. Oh, yeah. Keep hitting me. I'm not gonna do anything. I'm strong enough. So, Creeparian and Ziggy D, you guys can check them out on YouTube if you're interested in this game, Path of Exile, that I am currently playing with pleasure. Yeah. You can check these guys out, and they really have extensive tutorials of how to play this game. Sweet. What's going on here? Okay, there's a wall. I can see over here that three of my gems are almost to the point where I can level them up to the next level. Now, some of them are grayed out because I've leveled them up to the max level, and there is no more levels that they need to that they can go up to. So that's it. I've reached maximum level on these gems. Okay, let's open here. Okay, yeah, we're currently revealing the map. We want to see what's going on in here. And I have the tendency to replay the same levels over and over again. As I said, the levels are randomized, so they're never exactly the same. But even though when I complete the missions over there, I still enjoy going back and just redoing the same thing a few times, so I can level up my character. And this way I'm gonna be better prepared for what's coming next. Okay, there's some kind of a ruined house of sorts. Let's check in. Oh my god, what have you been eating? My goodness, lordy lord. I don't want these leather boots. Let's see.
I haven't slept. No one has slept. Not for 3 days, not since the black storm in the northern ranges. Not since the nightmares began. Violent and twisted night terrors. They whisper to us, tempt us, threaten us, beguile us. They promise terrible things in return for even more terrible acts. My husband, Deniris, went to Alistair to find a doctor who might help. He should have been back yesterday. I fear for him. I fear for all of us.
Interesting. I guess they were sick from something. Okay, we have another one over here.
It has been a little over a week since the black storm. My husband has not returned, and sickness now sweeps through our village. Many have died, and those who have lived have changed. These were folk we once called neighbor and friend. Now they limp and stagger through the night, their deformities as grotesque as the madness in their eyes.
Oh, they're turning into zombies, dude. Okay, so yeah, in this game, as far as I can tell, we're fighting the zombies and the undead. So you have a lot of skeletal... armor scrap. So you have a lot of skeletal creatures and scroll of wisdom, and a lot of undead creatures, besides all the bears and the rest of the creatures. Every area has different creatures, which is super cool. I mean, you know, for a free-to-play game, not even for a free-to-play game, for any game, what these guys did is amazing. I mean, this game is so vast and large and has such a deep lore. And I'm just surprised at how extensive this game is. And the developers decided that they're just going to release it for free. And yes, you can buy stuff from the actual shop. There is a shop that you can go to and buy stuff. But they're only cosmetic stuff, like if you want your armor to look better. It doesn't have better stats. It's not stronger armor than what you can find in the game. But if you just want the armor to look better, you can buy these custom looks, if you want to call them this way. Also, they are selling pets for some cheap prices. I mean, we're talking about $1 or $2 or $5, you know, and the pets will follow you everywhere you go, and it's going to be attacking the enemies just as you are attacking them. So that's pretty cool. Oh, this is a Papa Skeletor. Armor. Some farming skeletons. Okay, we're still trying to reveal the map. See where it's gonna take us. Oh, the Fell Shrine Ruins. Okay, I'll be right back. I just want to see what else we have over here. Yeah, I love to use these arrows, because I don't have to engage the enemies. I can just shoot from a distance, and by pressing shift and the attack ability, your character does not move forward, which is pretty cool. He or she will remain still. There is female characters too. There is a witch, and there is archer character. They're female characters that you can pick in the very beginning. Etching on wood. Oh, there is another scroll over here. Lunari, it means moons. Three moons, I think. Or maybe months.
and the moon will go on alone.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
My husband has returned and he hunts for me. My dead husband hunts me. Corrupted and my uncle. Corpses rise and walk and feed. My girls.
So this lady, Tanny, I guess her family died, and because they were sick, and then they became undead and they woke up and they tried to kill her. And yeah, apparently this is the last thing that she wrote, is that she's going back to her family, meaning that she's becoming an undead too, because they woke up and they attacked her. So that's pretty dark. Interesting. Alright. Moving on. Ooh, was ist das? The Broken Bridge. Ich bin vielen interessanten. I speak a little German, okay? So, just to let you know. Don't freak out. Ooh, I can hear somebody crying. I can hear somebody crying. Who is crying? Oh my lord. Lordy lord, what is that? Oh my god. Okay. Let's go inside. Ooh, who's that? Who's that? Bravallo. Hey, Bravallo. No, 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 no. Don't be reading that. Kill that guy first. Okay. Alright. Oh, she's talking about this dude. Okay, my blood is going down. Oh, I killed him.
My uncle tried to stop her. Bravallo crushed his skull with his smith's hammer. I barred the doors and windows, but they screamed.
Okay, lady, hold on a second. I want to hear you again. The moon was full the night of the black storm. It is full again. So a month later, they have come for me, her family, I think. Oh, no. Oh, Bravallo, the leader of the skulls came for her family. They were already turning into undead, so Bravallo came to collect them, pretty much. That's what I'm understanding.
The doors and windows, but they screamed like monkeys and beat themselves bloody trying to get in.
Oh,
I had
boy.
No choice. I took my two youngest and fled through the cellar, following the tunnel to the mill. All we can do is hide and hope.
So the mother that is writing the scrolls, she did not give up her family. She went into hiding with her family that is already turning into undead. How they're turning into undead. Now she's talking about nightmares that these people started having, and then they started changing. Very weird and odd. Very dark, dark story. So this game is New Zealandish game from New Zealand, which is the island right next to Australia over there, where the Lord of the Rings was filmed at. So, okay, I've been here already. So there is a lot of Maori names, and I believe Maori legends that are implemented into the game's lore, which is, I find this very attractive and very original. If you guys have played Diablo 2, Sacred 2, this is exactly that kind of a game. And I'm a big fan of Sacred 2 and Diablo 2, so that's why I started playing this one. And it does not disappoint a single bit. Let me have a little more a Red Bull, or as a friend of mine was calling this, Blue Balls. Oh. Oh. You little bloody bastard. You trying to approach me from behind. This is not cool. Okay, I believe I have revealed everything. So, we are going inside here. The Fell Shrine Ruins. Don't know what that is. Never been here before. Now, over here I have two subquests: travel to the Broken Bridge or the Western Forest, and travel to the Broken Bridge, the Bandit Lord Allura. No idea what. Probably I have to find these people and talk to them or kill them or whatnot. Oh my god, what is this? Okay. Let's see. Let me send some of these. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna just change the gameplay a little. And what I'm gonna do instead is I'm gonna use my Wolverine Forks. See? Now, out of my left hand over here, I changed weapons. Now, I'm not using the arrows, I'm using the Wolverine Forks. Out of my left hand, I'm releasing magma, which is like a lava-like thing. And out of my right one, it's like a force, a circle of force that keeps expanding as I'm hitting and hitting more enemies. So there's the lava, and there's the circle. Okay, what am I to do with this? 18 seconds. What is this? Portal scroll. Now, with the portal scrolls, you can open a portal and go, and which is going to lead you directly to the main city, where is the safe haven, pretty much. So you can unload your inventory to a vendor and then come back to the field of action. A chest. Scroll of Wisdom. I always need Scroll of Wisdom. I always need. Oh my god. I talk like freaking, what do you call this thing? Smeagol. Smeagol wants it. Alright. Keep hitting. Let the magma flow. Let the magma float. Oh yes, keep coming. I love you guys. Oh, there is a gem right here, a red one. Now, that's a support gem. This supports a major gem. And yes, I definitely love to collect that. All right, come on, guys. Now, also in these slots over here, I have different abilities. So pretty much, if you guys have played any MMORPG, and most of them are free, MMORPG stands for massive multiplayer online. Yes. So this is World of Warcraft. This is Guild Wars 2. This is Arcage. You have these slots where you can load them with different types of actions. So for example, if I press that, I can load something else instead. So this is left button, middle button, and right mouse button. So this is the mouse buttons. And then I have the Q on the keyboard, W-E-R-T. So for example, if I press the button W, I'm releasing skeletors. Skeleton creatures, they're gonna help me fight the enemy. I think that's pretty cool. Now, they don't follow me, they're gonna stay over here because they're stupid. They don't have any brains. But I have other skills. For example, if I press the middle mouse button, I can curse these guys. You see, this ability is curses all the targets in the area, making them more vulnerable to stuns. Sweet. Alright. Okay. Let's keep revealing the map. See where it's going to take us next.